Hey guys, how's it going? Slick here, and today I want to talk to you about why Destiny 2 seems to be pretty disappointing overall. I know what you're probably thinking. Slick, you fat dipshit. They only showed some Destiny footage a couple days ago. You've never played the game. It is an alpha build. Why are you so fat and or stupid? Now, me being fat and or stupid, yeah, that is, you're very spot on, alright? The fact of the matter is that Bungie at a reveal event, right? They're like, alright, we're gonna go big, we're gonna go hard, we're gonna show Destiny 2, right? This is their big reveal, right? And so, this is their first impression. They gotta make a good one, right? They gotta show everybody, you know, hey, we're here to kick ass, right? And from what they've shown me, them putting their best foot forward, I am very, very disappointed in what I'm seeing, alright? I'm very disappointed in what I'm seeing. Alright, if people are allowed to be super hyped and excited about, like, yeah, I'm so fucking pumped, I'm certainly allowed to be like, oh man, really? Oh, that's a bummer, right? And so, yeah, it's probably a little preemptive, right? But we're gonna get to that. I'm basing it off of everything they've shown so far, right? Because I can't base it off of shit that nobody has seen before, right? Because how would I even know that it exists? I'm only basing on what we've seen so far and what they've showed us and told us, alright? So first up, let's talk about the good stuff. It's not all the world is ending stuff, but let's talk the good stuff first up. It looks like Destiny 2 actually gonna have a story. They're actually gonna have a story. That's great, right? So far, the premise is amazing, right? Chilling in the tower, right? Drinking a pina colada, whatever. And all of a sudden, oh shit, things are going down. There's explosions. We're being frontal assaulted and attacked. The Traveler is lights being siphoned. Right, we've lost our light. Oh boy, what a
pickle we've found ourselves in right here.
Got to fight Gary, rescue the Traveler, regain our light. Right, the premise is fucking outstanding. Very good premise. Right off the bat, you know exactly what the fuck you're going in and getting. Right there, boom, very good stuff. Right, the cinematics. I don't give a shit, really. I never gave a shit about cinematics. As long as there's a story there, right? As long as the world is interesting, the characters are interesting, boom. All right. Destiny 1, the story was shit, and the environments were garbage, right? Technically, it was outstanding, right? Everything looked amazing. The skyboxes were beautiful, right? From a technical standpoint, everything looked amazing. But the world was dead. Compare that to something like Fallout New Vegas. Fallout New Vegas has blocky shit textures. Everything is beige. Right? It's really outdated, but the world in Fallout New Vegas is alive and it's just infinitely better than Destiny, right? You go, who is that guy? I want to talk to that guy and figure out what his story is, right? Because he has a story and it's fucking interesting. I want to go to that place over there because that place is going to have a story and it's going to be a good story. Fallout is filled with just interesting places, interesting people, and stories just fucking everywhere, right? It's all, the main storyline is whatever, who cares? But like, the world building in Fallout New Vegas is amazing. Right? It's literally the opposite, the exact opposite of Destiny, right? The yin to its yang, right? Destiny has got barren, boring-ass worlds with nothing interesting going on in them. They have no character who gives a shit. But amazing gunplay. All the gunplay is so good, right? Fallout has such garbage gunplay. They're like, just use VATS. We put this in here. It'll do the shitty gunplay part for you so you can experience all the good parts of the game, right? Destiny's very beautiful. All the environments are really well done. Fallout, really blocky. Really, you know, they reuse a lot of elements. But still, the world feels so much more alive in Fallout than it ever did in Destiny, right? So Fallout did all of that stuff great, and Destiny fucking failed at it, right? So hopefully Destiny 2, the worlds are interesting to be at, and you want to go, like, in Destiny 1, it's a fucking meme, right? Oh, what? Well, let's go in this cave. What's in this cave? Oh, it's a meme. It's a meme about the time where the developers had their heads so far up their asses that they didn't have any idea what people wanted in terms of fun, so we would sit for hours and shoot into a fucking cave to get loot. Let's put a meme in there, right? Instead of, you know, putting interesting shit everywhere like they did in Fallout New Vegas, right? Now, I know that Fallout 4 came out, and I've heard bad things where they dumbed it down, right? They bumped up the gameplay, but they removed kind of the world character. And I haven't played it yet, but Fallout New Vegas is probably my favorite first-person experience of all time. And if Destiny 2 can capture even a little bit of the world building that New Vegas had, right? Just a little morsel, then Destiny 2 is you know, building up to be a very good PvE experience, right? I think the PvE is going to be very strong. What they showed, I think they've learned from their mistakes. I think that the primary campaign is going to be good. I think it's going to be interesting. The premise they're starting off with is very good, right? And like I said, they've learned so much from PvE. The strikes are going to be better. The raid hopefully should be great, right? So overall, I think that all those things are strong. Everything else, the clan stuff, that's all really great stuff, but I will never interact with any of that, so I don't give a shit, right? My only concern is just making sure that the environment is alive, right? It's just not a bunch of social places where you talk to NPCs and there's menus and they give you, you buy a thing, right? I really want there just every location to have a story. I want it to be interesting in that regard, all right? So overall, I think the plot's gonna be better. All that stuff, that's great. PvE is gonna be better. And then we get to the section where it starts to look really bad. First off, all the new classes are replacing old classes. So it's not that we have more classes to choose from, we have the same amount, only we've gotten rid of some of the old ones and now we've replaced them. And we didn't even really get rid of them, we gave them a new name. The Dawnblade, I believe, is the new Sunsinger. The Super, that's really cool, but it looks a lot like Hammer of Soul, where you throw stuff at people, right? He does have like kind of a move where he can kind of travel downwards and do a slam, right? But that's also in Destiny 1, that's not really new. The Dawnblade's abilities, the grenade, solar grenade, fusion grenade, and firebolt grenade. You know, the same grenades you've been using for the past 3 years. That has me a little bit, like, skeptical. The glide is the same, focus burst, you know, balance glide, more controlled glide, whatever those are, right? The Striker Titan's in the exact same situation, flashbang, pulse lightning, increased control, catapult, increased height, all the same shit you've had for the past 3 years. That is like an alarm bell in my head going, but I'm sick of that shit. But no more, please, right? They removed Titan Skating. They removed Titan Skating, all right? And they didn't replace it with anything interesting. It looks like, to me, movement is slower and clunkier, and gunplay is slower and clunkier. And by clunkier, I just mean they were probably using garbage weapons, because everybody looked like they never played a first-person fucking shooter before, spraying fucking bullets everywhere. It's like, are these the really good players that I've watched just hit insane shots, just fucking bullets everywhere? Their guns are probably ass. But regardless, the times to kill are definitely slower. So overall, PvP appears to be slower, which is not what I want. I don't want a slower tactical shooter. I want a fast-paced arcade shooter. Because that's what Destiny was, right? When I bought Vanilla Destiny and I played it for hours and hours, right? Back when that game was just a piece of shit. It was a 6 out of 10, right? Big piece of shit game, right? We stuck with it. The Destiny people, we stuck with it. We're like, man, this is like really fast-paced. It's got lightning in a bottle, despite the fact that there's not a whole lot of it, and they kind of fucked up a whole bunch of shit. It's still like, it's right there. And they're taking that, right, the people that stuck with the game since the shitty-ass launch when nothing was there, right? And I feel like they're just kind of trampling on them, because they're just slowing down the game. They're removing the thing that all those people from the beginning stuck with till the end right now, and it's like, by the way, that thing that you loved even when it was shitty, well, it's gone now, and we got a new version that's slower, and it's more like Halo, and it's like, no, I don't want that. I want the fast arcade version. No, better yet, all PvP is 4v4. It's all 4v4, which is intrinsically slower.
But slick, they designed the PvP for a 4v4 experience.
All right, well, Asylum, the map Asylum was designed for 3v3. And yet, I can play fucking Control on that. They're like, you know what, fuck it, Sixes on that map. I guarantee you, if I play Sixes on Asylum, it's gonna be more fast-paced than if I play Fours on Asylum. And that's what I want. I want fast-paced, fun action, right? Now, I would have no problem if during the press conference, if during the reveal, they were like, we gotta have a new competitive mode. 4v4 competitive mode. So we're gonna have ranked playlists, it's gonna be 4v4, right? Because we feel 4v4 is more measured, more controlled, and we can control that. But, we've designed all the maps for these modes. But we know you guys like to fuck around and just have a blast playing video games, just kind of a more fun party environment. So we're gonna have Sixes as well, but it's gonna be unranked and it's just kind of be for fun, right? They didn't say that though, they said all game modes are 4v4, which means boom, intrinsically, immediately slower gameplay. Just immediately. Furthermore, Titan Skating's gone. I've watched people use the lift abilities, use the jump abilities in the game. All of those are slower and clunkier. All fast movement abilities are gone. Blink wasn't shown. They didn't show Blink. Now, I have this sneaking suspicion that they're gonna get rid of Blink. I have the sneaking suspicion there's no more Blink. Because I don't know how Blink fits into this much, much slower gameplay where it just doesn't become like the best movement option bar none. But that's jumping the gun a little bit. It is an alpha, and of course they're still holding some cards close to their chest. Maybe I'm full of shit. Regardless, movement abilities are slower and clunkier. Times to kill are slower, they're longer. And it's 4v4. So everything is saying we're moving this from fast-paced arcade to slower tactical shooter, and none of that pleases me because I don't want that shit. I don't want Halo. Nobody wants Halo, which is why nobody's playing or buying Halo, right? Unfortunately for the Halo people, right? If you like Halo and you enjoy it, that's fine. Play the game, and I'm sorry it's not as successful as it used to be. But people have moved on. There's a reason nobody's playing Unreal Tournament right now, right? Because at the time, it was fucking amazing, right? Oh, I'm so innovative. But then newer games came out and do newer, better things, right? And we're past that. We're past that. But now they want to go back to that. And I'm like, why are you going back? You had something new that despite its horrible launch, people stuck with. That could have fucking sunk your company how shittily you launched that game. But people stuck because you caught lightning in a bottle and you're like, wow, this bottle sure is bright and filled with lightning. Ah, fuck it. Let's bring in this bottle and fill it with diarrhea, right? Old diarrhea that we've already done before, right? You remember back in 2003 when we made this diarrhea? Let's make it again. So the gameplay looks slower. I don't like it. A lot of the class abilities look identical to what they were before. I don't like that as well. The new abilities, warlocks can now drop like a pool of light, which, you know, is blessing light and weapons light, which is new. That's new. We've never seen that before, right? That's certainly a new element to the game. Hunters now have like this little dashy thing that's kind of like, you know, like if you were to like step into the shade and hide, right? It's kind of like a roly kind of dodge move, right? That's new to Destiny. Like, we've never seen that before. Titans can make walls and like, you know, barriers and stuff. We haven't seen that before. So it's all very new and exciting, except the opposite. I will argue that, yeah, it is. I mean, they're just using old elements in a new way, but I feel like here's Destiny 1, and here's my expectations. Boom! Destiny 2, just like fucking right there. Everything Destiny 1 had, but bigger and better, right? But what they did was Destiny 1, Destiny 2. I'm like, well, that's neat, but that's a lateral movement, right? You move to the right, to a more tactical, slower game where everything is still kind of intact, but there's not a whole lot. I don't see a lot of improvements. I'm not seeing the improvements that make me go, fuck yeah! Now, this is all based off the fact that I play the game 95% in PvP. What I'm seeing, I don't like. I don't like the slower times to kill. If I did, I would be playing a different game than Destiny. I don't like these slower movement abilities. Same exact thing. I would be playing Halo if I wanted to. I don't like the clunkiness of it. Also, I don't like the old abilities coming back. Now,
but Slick, this is an alpha. They could be holding stuff back.
That is entirely true. Part of me has the sneaking suspicion that this reveal event was for everybody who is a non-Destiny fan. I have the sneaking suspicion they said, you know what, fuck all the diehard Destiny fans that have been there with the beginning. We need to regain all these people that said, Destiny, what a hunk of shit that is. People still play this game? We need to get those guys. And so what they realize is, all right, so those guys know that make the joke of Destiny not having story. So we got to show a million cinematics and really pump up that, boom, we have characterization, boom, we have a story, boom, we have a fucking great premise for a story. And you know exactly what that premise is, and we have time to explain, right? Why, boom, it's all right there. We're gonna show you a bunch of fucking awesome environments, which they nail every time. The technical, it just, everything looks awesome, right? Easy peasy, awesome looking environments, right? Whether or not there's anything interesting to do in those environments besides shoot shit is another thing that's yet to be discovered. But we're all used to that stuff. We're all used to awesome technical stuff, shooting shit. We're all about that, right? And that's why I think that the reveal is a disappointment to me, because they didn't show us anything that blew me away. I'm like, oh yeah, no, it's all the shit that I'm aware of that, but where's the new stuff? Where's the stuff that's gonna take it off the top? And what I think they're doing is, they're going, all right, people who wrote off Destiny aren't gonna know that Flashbang Pulse and Lightning Grenade, you know, have been around for 3 years, right? They're not gonna know about Titan Skating, right? They're not gonna even give a shit that it's gone. So we need to get all these people who wrote off Destiny for being a big hunk of shit, show them that we fixed all of the problems that everybody had with it, right, and now it's new. And all the old diehards are like, but what about Titan Skating? I like that. What about Arcade Shooter? That's fast time to kills. I like that. What about that? Right? It's not Destiny anymore. It's a new game. You made it for the non-Destiny people. That's where I'm sitting at right now. They made a Destiny 2 for non-Destiny people. And they're banking on Destiny people going, you know what? We're going to pay for it. We're going to give it a shot because I like Destiny so much. And they're just banking on people who don't like Destiny to kind of translate into Destiny. And so that's why I think they have no problem showing us the same exact class abilities that we've had for the past 3 years, and only making minor modifications to existing classes, while removing classes at the same time. Sunsinger, as far as I'm aware, is no longer there. Now, another problem which is just really egregious, that has me the most concerned, is that in Destiny, if you consider your grenade ability, your melee modifier, your movement modifier, your jump modifier, your super modifier, and your perks, your class perks, you have column A and column B, right? All those modifiers, you have 243 different combinations of loadouts. Each subclass has 243 different variations. Not counting just recovery, armor, and agility. Not counting those nodes, right? Just the number of different combinations you can run is 243 per subclass, right?
But Slick, some of those combinations are fucking terrible. Like Vortex Mastery on a Voidwalker, where you don't run any area of effect abilities.
Yeah, that's true, right? If you're not running fucking Vortex on your shit, or Black Hole, or whatever. I don't know what the perks are called. I don't play Voidwalker, right? You're wasting your perk and you look like an asshole. That is true, right? 200 out of 243, only a small amount are viable, right? People are just like, you know, Touch of Flame, Bike, if you're a Sunsinger, everybody ran only that build, right? In fact, the problem is that, though, you always had the option to be a dickhead and goof around and run Angel of Light, Solar Wind, and fucking Sunbreakers with solar grenades if you wanted to. You had that option, right? In the new version of Destiny, in Destiny 2, they give you perk packages. So you have four perks up here and four perks down here, and you have the option of one or two. I did the math, and you can run 36 variations in Destiny 2. Each subclass has 36 variations, 36 combinations, which is less than 15% the number of variations in Destiny 1. So you are getting considerably less customization in Destiny 2 than in Destiny 1, which is a fucking travesty.
But Slick, what if they just remove the garbage perks?
What if they do that? What if they only leave the good perks, alright? Now, I don't have the option of running stupid trash perks just to be a dickhead and have fun, right? The people that wanted to run the streamlined best build all the time can already do that in Destiny 1, but now I don't have the option of running the shitty stupid ass build. Right? Like, it literally reduces my fun and enjoyment of the game, right? If I wanted to run, Omnigold Strike's the perfect example. When I play that strike, I run multiple builds. At the beginning, I run Armor of Light, Relentless, and Gift of the Light, right? I drop my bubble, the thralls pour in, I punch a million of them into orbs, right? I also run Untouchable, so I get my bubble back faster. Punch them all in the orbs, keep dropping my bubble over and over again, Armor of Light, you know, Blessing doesn't stack with Force Barrier, so I use Armor, so they come in and hit me, but I keep my Force Barrier forever. Punch like a million of them in orbs. Next part, I switch off Armor, I switch to Blessing, and I switch to Gift of the Void, right? And then what happens is that the dropshits come in and drop off enemies and shoot my bubble, make orbs for my teammates use the orb, kill the enemies as they come out of the ship, move on to Omnigull. Then I switch to Bastion, right, because I want my bubble up as long as possible, and I use suppressor grenades for that part. I suppress Omnigull, I fuck her ass up until she's unsuppressed, drop my bubble, blind her with her bubble, keep fucking her ass, right, just keep doing it, and then when my bubble goes and she's unblinded, I use the suppressor grenade I got from dropping my bubble to suppress her again to do more damage, and then I run the fuck away, right? That's three unique builds in one fucking strike. And you're telling me, Slick, you can't do that anymore because the asshole just runs the same build all the time. Now we've streamlined it. I don't want it streamlined. I don't want it streamlined, right? If I want to run some goofy-ass, stupid-ass build, right, I should be allowed to run the dumbest build in the world, right? The people that are going to run the optimized build can already do that in the current Destiny 1 landscape. It's just now the people that want to goof around and have fun, they no longer have the option. Which is a fucking travesty, in my opinion. Also, there's something to be considered. What if one of the perk trees is garbage? What if then? Right? People are like, but Slick, some of the builds in Destiny and some of the perks are just absolute trash. You're right, Solar Wind is garbage. It's garbage on Sunsinger, right? But shouldn't Bungie, instead of just making less perks so that, you know, the perks that they have are better, shouldn't they just make better perks? They're the game development company, right? It's like having a painter who paints less, right? Because he's not good at it. It's like, why don't you just get better at painting so when you make a painting, it's a good one, right? Just make good perks. Like, just have, like, 30 good perks, right? Why not just do that? Oh, I know that's easier said than done, right? But the fact of the matter is that Destiny 1 has trash perks. What are the odds that Destiny 2 has zero trash perks, right? So let's just imagine a world where Destiny 2 has less choice for you, less customization, but also trash perks. So you have even less options, right? You have even less options. From a video Mtash made about the Dawnblade, it would appear that one of the perks is just better than the other, right? So now you have only 18 options. You have 18 options, right? So regardless of how you set up the perk tree, there will always be an optimal build, and people will always run that. However, you have not given people the opportunity to run fun optimal builds. You've reduced the ability to customize the game in order to make it easier to balance, which is a cop-out. You're just copping out. You could really sit down, put in the effort, think up good perks, right? If one doesn't work, you change it, right? But you copped out, you reduced the amount of customization because it's easier. It is easier. It certainly is easier to balance 36 different combinations than it is to do 243. But it's not as fun. There's a reason that Destiny has Striker, has Voidwalker, and they all have their own abilities, because that shit's fucking fun, alright? There's a reason you just didn't launch Destiny where everyone was Master Chief and everybody has the same abilities. There's a reason why when you get a fighting game, it's not just Ryu versus Ryu, but you also play as Zangief if you want to. And they all have their different personalities, they all look different, and they all have their own different gameplay styles. That's because variety and fucking all that shit is fun. It's fun to have that stuff. And what you've done is you've gone, we want it to be easier for us to make a better game, so we've just sapped all the fun out of it, right? So that's where I'm at right now. I'm really disappointed from everything I've seen from Destiny 2. PvE, I'm sure, will be great. I'm hoping that their storytelling is not the same kind of shit we saw from the Taken King in Rise of Iron, which is, it's competent, but there's nothing about it that really inspires any type of wonder or awe in me. It's competent storytelling. The story was just kind of boring and stupid. The premise for Destiny 2 appears to be very good, but it really depends on how they really tell the story, right? PvE, all that stuff looks great. The new classes, they removed classes to put the new classes in. New classes have a lot of the same abilities old classes had. I saw Sentinel. Sentinel had Magnetic Grenade, and it looked like he had Disintegrate from the skill tree in the bottom left-hand corner. It just looks like more of the same. I guess it's on me. I think at the end of the day, this is just on me having much higher expectations than what Bungie was delivering. And so right now, that's probably what you're thinking, Slick, you put the game on a pedestal and you just thought, you know, you thought all of these things, and when none of them came true, now you're sad. And so what I'm doing is the opposite now. I'm expecting nothing, and then I will be pleasantly surprised. I was at the point where I was so excited for Destiny 2. I thought of all the things they could do, all the things to expect. I thought new elements, right? Solar, Void, Arc, and now Frost element, maybe? Right? A Frost element? How cool would that be? Right? Maybe a couple more elements. What if you could play as an Elixini, right? A Fallen. Oh man, that would be super cool, right? But so far, they have shown none of that stuff. There are more things to be shown. It's just an alpha. Maybe they'll show more stuff at E3. Maybe they have so much stuff that they're playing this, they have all their cards in their hand, they're hiding it, and I just look like a complete asshole in a couple of months where they just blow everybody out of the water, right? But for me, this reveal was not for Destiny fans. This was for everybody else who had abandoned the game and made memes about Destiny being garbage to try to get them back into it, and they're banking on people who like Destiny already to stick around. Regardless, the PvP, it just looks slower. It looks like more of the same. And so, like I said, I went in with high hopes, and now I'm just kind of down in the dumps. So now I'm going in with no hopes. I'm expecting Destiny 2 to have a very competent and fun PvE experience for quite a while. I will not play the game that long because PvE is not my thing. I feel like PvP, from what I've seen, will be a slow-paced fuckfest. Will not be what I want. Now, there's nothing wrong with that, right? If you like Halo, you like the more tactical shooter, right? I don't, right? And that's not what Destiny ever was. Never was it that. So they're making it into something it's not. I feel like it's a direct slap in the face into all the people that stuck around back when the game was fucking shit. Who stuck around through the garbage times. I feel like it's a slap in the face to them. Because you've made the game something that I don't think it ever was. Right? You're trying to make it into a shittier version of Halo. Right? And you're not that. You made something, you caught lightning in a bottle, you made something amazing, and I feel like you're backtracking on it. And it's just really, it's not for Destiny players. It's for everybody else, right? Like I said, so I'm going in with no expectations. I'm expecting it to be bad. That way, if it's good, I'll be pleasantly surprised. Otherwise, if I'm going with hype and it comes out and I'm disappointed, I'm gonna look like an asshole, like I do right now, right? So that's about it for the video. I know it's a little bit long-winded. Just fucking deal with it. Watch it or don't. Or, I mean, you're already here, so you're fucking watching it. I tricked you, you fucking assholes. That about does it for me. What I'd like you guys to do is post in your comments your initial reaction to the Destiny reveal stream. What I would like you guys to do is once Destiny 2 comes out in the beta and you play the beta, I want you to come back and comment on your own comment and, you know, talk about whether or not you were right in your initial assertion, whether you were wrong, you know, and then, you know, how you feel after the fact. And also, I'd like you to comment, and if I turned out to be very wrong down the line, Destiny 2 launches, wait for the launch, right? Wait for a couple months after the launch. Destiny 2 comes out, and it turns out to be a masterpiece and everything that everybody wanted it to be. I want you to come back to this video, and I want you to type, Slick, you are a fat, stupid shithead, right? So I'm expecting a bunch of comments come November 2017, that just a stream of comments on this video that say, Slick, you are a fat, stupid shithead, because nothing would make me happier than to be wrong. Anyways, that about does it for me, guys. Go fuck yourselves.